Hey, what's up, you guys?
Hello, everyone.
We are here today at Universal Studios. Whoop! Helicopter. We are here today at Universal Studios to check out the Christmas stuff because Halloween Horror Nights has ended. But yeah. What did Island of Adventure have?
They have Christmas decorations.
Way before like Halloween, right? Like a week before Halloween.
Yeah, before it ended, you mean?
Before Halloween Day and it ended.
Right, yes.
It was on, what was it? It was on Dr. Seuss and then like Hogsmeade, right?
Yes.
So do you think they decorated Diagon Alley and all the city and stuff in Universal?
Maybe, because it's Halloween have ended, right?
That's
so
true.
Let's go check it out. We're going to see.
Yeah, for sure. Let's go. Outside of the Universal Studios store, they have Grinch merchandise all ready to go. Has him in his little Christmas outfit. Alongside many other Grinch merchandise, including these Santa hats. It appears, as we're walking into Universal Studios, like towards the entrance, they have these food booths right over here. And I wonder if that's going to be part of their like Christmas offerings this year. Very interesting. I wonder if there's more inside of the park. Oh my goodness! They have decorated for Christmas here at Universal Studios. From the archways on like the left of the entrance to the main archway, all the way towards the right. It's very beautiful, all of the baubles on it. I like those ones with the hanging baubles. Those are very pretty. Do you know what's so crazy though? How this was decorated for what, HHN?
I know.
And now it's all just Christmas.
I know.
Out with the clowns, in with the balls.
Yeah. HHN is Halloween Horror Nights, right?
Yes.
And it just finished a couple of days ago.
Mm-hmm.
2 days ago, whenever.
I'm seeing how fast they've decorated.
Yeah.
Do you think they're going to decorate these palm trees?
Maybe.
Did they do that last year? I don't remember.
I can't remember really because it was our first time coming to you.
Oh, that's true. That's very true.
So we really don't know.
Mm-hmm. So, Nan.
Yeah?
Now that we've crossed into Universal Studios.
Yeah?
You know what's so weird to see?
What?
There's no HHN sign.
I know.
There's no decorations. There's no markers for scare zones.
It's all gone, yeah.
That was the last we've been here.
Yeah, until next year. Please God, you know?
We're gonna do it.
Yeah.
I already get scared again.
Next year?
Yes.
Yeah.
What is it? You went in the one Beetlejuice house.
Yeah, that was good. I like that.
Yeah, because you like Beetlejuice. But enough about Halloween. It's Christmas time now.
Right.
God, it looks so weird. There's just nothing.
I know. Let's.
You think there's any merchandise?
Yeah, let's.
Oh, yeah,
see.
There's a Grinch Grinchmas merchandise. I know a lot of this. Oh, the sweater? It's $57.
Oh, wow, but it feels nice and warm.
It's a fleece sweater. Oh, the throw blanket. Yes, we should. If you guys don't know, Garmin's my cat. I'm taking care of him. He's my uncle's cat, but I'm currently taking care of him.
So cute.
And he likes all this stuff. He likes to go under your blanket.
Yeah.
Just stay there.
Look at this.
Oh, the little dog from the Grinch. How much is he? He is going to be $17. But he's very weighted. He has stand up.
Yeah, he has like a
antler.
And look at the Grinch himself here.
Oh, yes. He's also very weighted. He is going to be $14.95.
Oh, look,
a spirit jersey.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it says has the Grinch on the front. Mm-hmm. And the back, I think, just says, yeah, the Grinch. Whoop. These are going to be $55. I saw these last year.
Yeah, the Grinch is on feast mode.
Yeah, but these same merchandise I saw last year for Christmas.
Yeah.
It might have been rolled over because remember nothing much happened.
Yes.
Last year, yeah.
Yeah.
This is going to be this particular shirt. It's going to be $27.
And look at the
salt and pepper shaker.
Yeah.
Oh, that is so cute! Oh my goodness, we should get one for our table this year.
Yes. Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm. And Christmas.
Yeah.
$34.
Nice, you should get that one when you come in here. And
I have a scarf to match. Has a fleece Grinch hat for $24. There's also some gloves to go with it for $13. And then a matching scarf, it's a full set, for $18.95. And it's all fleece, so it's very warm.
And the bag.
Oh, the backpacks. Here's a Loungefly Grinch backpack. Now, the hat actually comes off of this thing, so if you want to wear it for Christmas or whenever, you totally can. The zipper on them, however, is also a little dog from the Grinch. And then they have all the different Dr. Seuss ornaments here as well. Nan, we should do one for the tree.
Yeah.
We totally should.
We got one similar to this for the tree crawler.
That one, it has like the Universal Studios emblem.
Yeah, look at the hat.
The hats, yes, the Christmas hats for the Grinch. These are going to be $27. Outside of the Universal Studios store, it says, "Be a part of our holiday tribute store. We'll turn you into cartoon you to be placed on Earl the Squirrel's Wall of Fame." Now, they had this for Halloween. Do you remember the tribute store, Nanny? This was very similar to what they had for the tribute store. Remember the portraits on the wall? We're on Hollywood Boulevard and Ivor Avenue, and this little traffic light does work. It just switched to go. Wonder if it'll switch to red anytime soon. And it just flipped over to stop. So, Nan.
Yeah?
The Marianne's building.
Yeah?
Next to the Bourne Stuntacular. You see the Christmas hats on the
oh, yes.
On the lamppost.
Yes.
What about the wreaths and all the baubles up there?
It's beautiful, yeah.
Isn't it
Marianne's is a hat shop?
I think it's a jewelry store, one of them.
Yeah.
But Nan,
yeah?
Look at the lights too on the post, like the starlights.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. I didn't notice that.
Hey, yeah. What about all of the ones over there too?
Yeah, and the hats on the street lights.
I know, oh, those are the best.
Yeah.
And what about on the Brown Derby as well, Nan?
Yeah.
It's all themed.
Yeah, and look at Scooby-Doo bus.
Oh, they're getting ready to leave, that's why. Bye. So, Nan.
Yeah?
Look at all the decor, even on the race store.
Yes.
They don't have anything on the Bourne show, though.
No.
But the other stores are decorated.
I know, it's so beautiful.
Isn't it?
Yeah, do you... look at this one. Yeah.
Oh, that is beautiful. The Schwamm. Oh, the broadcast center. Yeah. It's a radio station center. That's what it is. But even like the Schwab's... Oh, that's a pretty blue.
Yeah.
On the pharmacy.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Look at the line to get in the store, Nan.
Holy moly.
We should go get our pins now.
Yeah, let's go because we never get it.
Yeah, again, this is for annual pass holders in the Universal Studios Lounge, which is right next to the Schwab's pharmacy. The decor here. I like how each of like the different decor here for like Christmas, but I'm saying it matches the theming of the store, like the colors match, they complement.
Yeah,
it's really nice. My favorite is definitely the back room though, how it has the silver decor to stand out against like the blacks and like the red even. It looks very pretty. They have a big Christmas wreath in front on top of the Five and Dime store, plus more gold decorations on the building alongside red wreaths and other woods. I'm so sorry about the wind, you guys. It's a very windy day here today at Universal Studios, alongside the other decor here at the park. Nan?
Yes?
They still have the horror makeup show going on.
Oh, really?
It's not a seasonal thing like I thought. It's every day.
Oh, okay.
So if you still want to get your Halloween spooks on.
Oh, okay. Then we'll...
Yeah.
You're disgusting. I love you.
Don't threaten me with a good time.
Oh, my.
Is
any broken?
So that's where they have
the... This conversation going on.
Yeah, is that the one back there? He is.
You know why this is my favorite?
Uh-huh.
It's vintage.
Yeah.
Because Mel's will be a 50s diner.
Yeah.
50s decorations.
Yeah.
Didn't you guys have ones like these? Oh, all the cars. They moved all the cars here.
Oh.
Oh, this was. Oh. I remember, Nanny.
Yeah.
Parking lots and diners. They were out in front.
Yeah, look at all of that.
Oh, Nanny! Come here, then. That's so pretty. The wreaths here at Mel's, they're vinyl records. You remember jukeboxes and diners. Oh, that is so cool. That is really cool. I love that. It's so cool I can see the engine bay of this 32 Deuce Coupe. This is really cool. Well, of course, in front of a drive-in, they'd always have old cars parked in front end.
Yes, the drive-in, yeah.
Do you know what you said? The social distance meet and greets here?
Yes.
Just be around here. I remember that. It was Scooby-Doo. Yeah. That used to be up here. I remember that.
Social meet and greets?
Social meet and greets, yes.
That's what I told you.
Ooh, this is a pretty one.
Yeah.
This old Ford. Oh, it's a Chevy. Oh, wait. Ooh. Not the Chevy. My bad.
Ooh.
Bel Air. Oh, didn't Dad have a Bel Air?
Yeah.
This is a beautiful car. They have more decorations here in New York. Looks very beautiful. Oh my goodness. Blues Brothers car is rolling around. They're gonna go perform right over there. Nan, it's so funny to hear Transformers music at Christmas. I mean, I have a quick question.
Yes.
The movie Die Hard is set around Christmas time.
Yes.
So does that make it a Christmas movie or not?
I don't know that one.
That's a good question though, isn't it?
It is.
Did it what?
When it released, did it have Christmas scene in
yes,
the movie?
Yes, and the movie setting was around Christmas too.
Oh, because I've never seen it, so I don't know.
I haven't either, but I'm just wondering, do you think it counts as a Christmas movie?
No, I don't think so.
I think it does. Any movie that has Christmas,
yeah.
No, it has to be. It has to be.
Okay.
Seems like they haven't decorated around there yet, but they have put the new flowers out in front of the founder statue.
It's not poinsettia, but I don't know if they were.
It's still very
Christmas colors.
It's still very Christmas themed, right?
Yeah.
Hey, Nanny.
Yeah?
They're playing this song the very first time we ever visited this side.
Yes.
The irony.
Yeah, I think maybe there's a loop they have.
No, it is a loop, but I'm just saying how nice of the timing.
Right, yeah. Coming back again?
Yeah. Richter's Burger Company. Oh my god, that looks good. The burger looks really good, man.
Yeah, it does. The big one is gone.
Oh, that mushroom one looks really good.
I know, truffle burger, that's
one. Oh, that looks good. San Andreas, yeah.
Oh, wow, it looks good.
Because Richter, like Richter scale.
Yeah, that's it.
You know it's supposed to be, right?
Yeah, like earthquake.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and there he is. Oh my goodness. Man.
Yeah?
Can you believe he was gone for so long?
Yeah, no, I can't believe that.
Can't?
No.
No, not at all.
So they have to refurbish them, right?
That's true.
Yeah.
I mean, he's back now.
Yeah.
We're here at Fisherman's Wharf of San Francisco while we're at Universal Studios. We're gonna be going to the Lombard's Landing for some lunch. Here's the menu for Lombard's Seafood Grill. Hey, Nan. Nanny.
Yeah?
They're the only place right now that's playing Christmas music.
Yeah. Yeah. The Bruce.
This is where we'll be eating at Lombard's Seafood Grill. Yeah.
Oh, it's beautiful in here. Look at the
face. I know.
It's
I like the color on it, like the oxidized copper.
Yes, yeah, nice ambience. Mm-hmm. And decorations and everything.
This looks nice to swim in.
Look what Coca-Cola Lounge is.
Oh, very old timey.
Yeah.
Looking.
This is the lot when you now walk in, right?
This is the entrance lounge.
Yeah.
Very beautiful.
Look at this thing on the sky.
Oh, the work on that. Yeah, that's gorgeous.
Yes. It looks like it's got like different. Like, I don't know.
Maya, party of four, Maya.
Hello. Thank you.
You're welcome.
The woodworking and all the detail in the restaurant is very beautiful. He's like copper bronze here, alongside all of the beams and the carvings on the woodwork and metal here. Very, very gorgeous. Very old-timey, like old San Francisco, which is very lovely. Seems like there's an aquarium over here as well, but I don't see any fish in it. So that's a surprise. Yeah, no, I don't see any fish in the aquarium here. Huh. Oh, wait, no, there's one. Oh, there they are. There they are. Oh, so lovely. I love aquariums in, like, any restaurant. Like, no matter what it is, they're just so lovely to look at. As usual, I got a virgin pina colada to drink. Dinner just arrived. I have the noodle bowl with the mahi. Has edamame mushrooms, soba noodles, a soft boiled egg. My grandfather got the cheeseburger. And my mom and my grandmother, they got the fisherman's basket to share, and then clam chowder each. Right in front of King's Cross Station, leading towards Diagon Alley and the Hogwarts Express, they have decorated right over here. You guys can see from the ends of each post. They've even decorated the lampposts here at King's Cross as well. There's a lot of decorations here, actually. They have on the train station itself. They even have by the garden right over here by the night bus. It looks very beautiful. Yeah, look at all, Nanny, look at all the decor in the train station.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they decorate more.
I know.
Absolutely
gorgeous. This is the fence I was talking about around the garden by the night bus. King's Cross Station?
Yeah.
They have more decorations here than last year.
Yeah.
What did I do?
Last year, King.
That's true, but look, they have like trees here. And even all the garland inside of here, Nan.
Yeah. Oh, it's pretty.
No, that is gorgeous. That
I
is
mean, it makes you feel like you're in London, right?
Well, of course, it's theming, Nan. Oh, it looks so pretty. Nan?
Yeah.
Nanny? How do you think Diagon Alley is decorated?
I don't know. We're gonna see, right?
Oh, yes, we are. Oh, that's... Oh, it's beautiful! They have decorated the Weasley Twins shop. Oh, Nanny, you have to come see this. Come here. Decor in the Quidditch shop.
Uh-huh.
It has the four houses.
Oh,
and then
yeah,
the golden in the center for the snitch.
Oh, okay.
Do you remember the little fast thing?
Yeah.
I want to point that out about the decor.
And it's all like Harry Potter team, like,
well, this is of course. And then on the Weasley store,
yeah,
it has like firecrackers and fireworks.
Yeah, and look at the broom is going
on. Oh, the firebolt, yeah. Did you even notice the fireball outside of the Quidditch shop?
No, because they always have so many
people
here.
Yeah. That's really cool, isn't it?
It's going up and down.
Well, it's magical.
Yeah. And the clothes hanging out to dry.
I mean, there's a lot of Christmas decor already from when you first walk in. So I wonder how the rest of the alley is going to look. The School Book store, Flourish and Blots. It has, the poinsettias are made out of pages of like book pages, paper. And then they have like the berries and like the soft lights around it. Here, let me show you guys a better view of those flowers. These are what they look like. That's so pretty. Oh my gosh. They have different baubles outside of the sweets and treats shop. And they also have more old-timey decorations right here by the hopping pot. There's even some on the owl area here. My goodness. It's very beautiful decorations here at Diagon Alley. There's even a small wand shop right over here across from the sweet store in case you don't want to wait for Ollivanders. Eternals. I don't know how much of you guys have noticed this, but they have different dark creatures on around like the tower. It has a Dementor, has a Thestral. Oh, there's a werewolf on this side. Let's see what other ones they have. Oh, they have a Oh, is that a dragon or a basilisk? It's a basilisk. There's a basilisk on this side.
Oh.
A unicorn over here. Then the last one I think is a hippogriff. Yep, it's Buckbeak. And we've never been in a lot of these stores.
I know, there's a lot of them.
We have to go through a lot of these things.
I know.
What, do you think one day we should make a shopping video?
Yes,
dedicated just to Harry Potter?
Yes. And look at all the decorations there. They make them look like real old times.
I know, I love this side, yes, that's why.
And just show this.
Spindle Wharfs, the tailor. Oh, it has balls of yarn hanging off. Yeah. Or look, the ribbons on Madame Madeleine's.
Yeah.
So there's a clothing store.
Yeah.
I know.
It's very interesting. It looks so themed, like real, like they're really in Harry Potter land.
Well, you know why?
Yeah.
Because J.K. Rowling oversaw everything.
Did?
When it was being built.
That's very smart of her.
That's why the shops and stuff are so claustrophobic.
I know.
To be like actually old English.
Yes. That's very smart.
It is. It's very smart of her.
Nana! You just
and even though it's so cold out?
I know, yeah. To enjoy everything.
It's like in the 50s now, it's freezing cold. There's still people out.
Yeah.
But Nanny,
yeah.
Is this supposed to be like, what is it, like the West Coast?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just it's fitting, it's just as cold.
Yes.
Seattle weather.
Yeah. But a lot of tourists, they if they come from north, they wouldn't feel the cold.
Wait a minute. Wait, I hate to cut you off. They just put the tree out. That wasn't there?
No,
that was not there, no.
Just pass around here.
I filmed the statue, right?
Yeah.
No, that was not there. Oh my goodness. Oh yeah. Hey, Ned.
Yes?
The Macy's is decorated.
Yes.
Now, what about the tribute store? That's coming soon.
Oh yeah.
Can you believe it? Are you excited?
Yes, I am.
What about, look at the Tribune store and stuff too. Well, that's the ride entrance, sorry.
The what?
The Tribune.
Oh yeah.
And then the store next to that, yeah. Oh, it's gorgeous, isn't it?
And under the tree.
The tree?
They haven't decorated yet. But
oh no, they have the star on top.
Yeah, but it's a fake tree, you know.
Yeah, true.
It's not like the one in Rockefeller Center in New York, I think.
Rockefeller, New York, yeah.
Rockefeller Center or whatever.
Yeah.
Called. Yeah, okay.
Interesting. There's more hats on the lights.
Oh yes.
We have a lamppost in our yard.
Yeah.
Can you put a Santa hat on it?
Maybe.
If we find one.
Oh Nan, the Monster Cafe is closed.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh yeah.
I have to wonder though, do they ever open it for like regular, or was it only during HHN?
I don't know.
Because remember, so Shrek 4D ride's closing down.
When?
Next year, January.
Uh-oh.
I really...
But it's one of the classic rides they have.
It was like one of like, yeah, like very close to opening day.
Oh, okay.
Well, so I don't know why they're taking it out.
Oh, maybe I don't know.
What do you think they're going to replace it with?
I really don't know. You sure it's not for refurbishment?
No, it's gone. It's being taken out. It's
okay.
Gone. Do you think it's going to be Nintendo themed? Because Universal has that deal with Nintendo.
I really don't know. It will be interesting to see what they're going to put here.
That is true. That is true. Well, it's freezing cold.
It is.
Which is why we kept our masks on to our outro.
Keep my face warm.
Keep our face warm.
Yeah.
So, what? It's Florida. It's so cold, man.
I know.
Why is it so cold?
I don't know. Winter is coming in all the other states, so maybe we're getting the cold weather here. I don't know.
I know.
Well, you know, get down to here. Get down to all 40 degrees.
30 degrees.
30 degrees, all that. So.
Hit 20s once, too.
Yeah. So
yeah, it could start snowing.
Yes.
Well, this was a fun visit here to Universal Studios regardless, right?
Right, yes.
I mean, what did we see today, Nanny?
Oh, we came here to see the decorated on Universal side.
Yeah.
We know they did it in
Islands of Adventure.
Right.
But now they did Universal.
Yes, so they didn't do it fully decorated yet because they just bought out a tree.
Yeah.
But they do have some stuff, you know, so it was nice.
It was very nice.
And then
see.
We had lunch.
Yeah.
A late lunch at Lombardi's. That was good.
That was pretty good, yeah.
Yes. So. No.
So, that concludes today's video.
Yes.
And thank you all so much for watching this video. If you're already subscribed to the channel, thank you very much, because that does mean a lot to us. For those who have not subscribed to the channel yet, what should they do?
Hit the subscribe button, like, and share.
What about the bell icon?
And the bell icon, so they will never miss a video from you.
Exactly.